Hi, this is Sky Ferreira, and you're watching PunchBowl TV. Keep it here. My father is Portuguese and Brazilian, and my grandmother is Native American, or my mom's side of the family is Native American. And I was born and raised in Los Angeles, and then I moved to New York about like 2 months before my 18th birthday. I got into music, well, I was always pretty much singing my whole life, but professionally I got into music at, I don't know, I'd say about 13 or 14. I met Rankin on a Dazed and Confused shoot, and he shot like 4 pages with me, but then that was like a lot of pictures, obviously. It was like an all day thing. And then I still kept in contact with him, and I had to do a music video for him. I didn't like any of the treatments. And he was like, well, you should send the song to Rankin and see what he says. And then Rankin's like, let's do it next week. I was like, okay. And we both came up with like a treatment, how we wanted it to look and like visuals and stuff. It's so funny. It was so funny. Like, I remember they drilled me in there. They had to drill like my head in the box. And I freaked out because the drill was like right in front of my face, just going down. I was like, and it was getting filmed when I was like a B-roll. I want to like find it, and like just use it as a viral. What one thing would I take on a desert to? Well, it depends if there's phone service on my phone. It's terrible to say, but it's true. It was like a never-ending battery. Cause then I could get off the island somehow, but, or a boat. I wash my hair. Looks like I don't, but I do. Robert Pattinson is probably my guilty pleasure. It's so like cliche and everything, and I'm like, but I'm open with it now. I've said it in like everything. Maybe eventually he'll like pay attention. Thick Piece of Me by Britney Spears, or Like a Prayer by Madonna. Yeah, I wrote a song for her. She never actually ended up doing it, but I wrote a song for her. A lot of people have written songs for her. But also we work with a lot of the same people, so that probably had something to do with it. But I'm hoping in the future that I could have like a collaboration with her, but am I? Not quite yet. I wrote a song for Miley Cyrus, Jedward, which was kind of just like, I decided to do it just because I thought they were really funny and like, they were actually really nice. They're like sweet guys, so I session came about, at first we wrote the song Overplayed, which was kind of like funny and silly. I mean, no one's ever heard it. But then he had this song called Obsession that he originally pitched to like a whole bunch of other people at first. But then like people would put it down and it just didn't quite seem right. And the thing is with that song, you can't take yourself too seriously because it's very like in your face and like, it really kind of takes a lot of nerve to sing it because it seems like it's about narcissism, but there's so many other meanings to it. But it's just like, you know, I think somehow I was able to do it. It was like pitched to like Rihanna, Adam Lambert, like all these like huge people. So, but whatever, another man's trash is another person's treasure. I had to compromise with it. I mean, I love the song and it's very poppy and stuff, but you know, it's, I think I just wanted to like try to push something a little different at first. But you know, I have to do what I have to do to get out. I mean, I don't like hate the song, but some song parts of it I don't really like. And some, I just really, I mean, it's obviously, I think it's still different from all the other pop songs out there a bit. Like there's still something different to it, but it's still very, very, very like recent. I always like to think, try to think ahead, you know. You make me feel like I'm living a teenage dream, the way you turn me on. I know Katy through your mutual friends.
It was actually a joke when I did the picture. I wasn't, like, serious. I didn't think I was looking hot with a vodka bottle being shit-faced and, like, wearing... I mean, I was wearing, like, the typical winter outfit for me in New York, which wasn't very smart. Like, fishnets and a mini dress and fur coat. I already looked kind of, like, prostitute-ish. But it's okay.
Most common misconception. I don't know, everyone always has something to say about anyone. I feel like it's just like, there's not like, I mean, of course there's like, oh, she's on drugs. I'm like, no, I don't do drugs. Or oh, she's like insane party girl, not that either. Or like, I'm mean or I'm like pretentious and I'm not, I don't like to think I'm any of those things. I don't think I am, but you know. My grandmother worked for Michael Jackson for like 30 years, so that's how I got to know him later on, or my family became very close with him. Just like going to Neverland and having my birthday parties there, because it was like amazing there. It was like Disneyland, but better. It was like, if you could play Disneyland 20 times better. The thing was, he wasn't there that often, so it's kind of funny how people just make it seem like he was there all the time, like riding all these rides, like in the middle of the day. It wasn't there. It was like, he had kids too. And he had family members that were kids. It was like for other people. So it was really irritating how people can make like something so great and someone who's been there to make something so great look so bad, and it wasn't at all. It was actually like 2 days before I signed. So it was a bit, it was very sad. And my mom, I wanted to have her fly back to LA, but she didn't want to go back because obviously it was a very big thing in my career. But I think he'd be happy to know that I was here working and doing music. At first, I freaked out when I was about to get the tattoo, like 5 minutes before. I was like, I don't think I could do it. He was like, he told me the story and he kind of guilt tripped me into doing it. I was like, oh, okay. And I was like, I was in shock how big it was at first. And I remember everyone's like, you got a tattoo and it looks like it's from like Lord of the Rings or something. It's like Lord of the Rings and Led Zeppelin put together. And I was like, yeah, I mean, I think it's actually kind of, I think it's really beautiful. It actually meant a lot to me. I think just the fact that I could make my own decision on what to put on my body and something so big to put on my body. I mean, it's not too out of the ordinary. I mean, you can go like downtown in New York or like in LA or London or anywhere and find people that dress like me. But I think it's just a matter of how you carry yourself to make it seem almost different. It's the West Coast where I'm like down guy, you know? And also, well, I mean, California is probably one of the most iconic songs of like the 20th century.
Film, I mean, I'll go back to, because I used to do film stuff, but I'll go back to film once I have more time. Just realistically, it just can't work because I'm always traveling. But I wouldn't mind trying other things. One.